So, it is week 3 of the shrinking mission, and how did I do? Well, you'll just have to wait and find out. As you guys all know, well, basically this past 2 weeks have been chaotic for me. Life has finally gotten into normalcy. My apartment is finally set up. There's no more boxes anywhere. And I decided that right now, doing the McCombs plan in this current stage of my life doesn't really make a lot of sense for me right now. I will go back into doing it at some point in time, but for right now, I'm counting calories. I recently just bought a program online called My Perfect Tracker or My Perfect Diet Plan or something like that. It's an application online. And so I'm going to be counting calories from now on. I think I have 1,400 calories a day that I can consume. So I'm changing my amount of allotted I'm changing what I'm doing to cutting calories and counting calories. And so far, it's going pretty well. I have gotten back on the diet, on the workout plan, and that has been going really well. I have been working out. Last week, I worked out for a total of 3 hours, which is a lot better than I have been doing. I actually worked out 3 hours. I went to the gym and clocked in those hours at the gym instead of counting moving and stuff like that. I actually got on the treadmill. And with saying that, here are some clips and some pictures of my workouts that I did this week of before and after. Okay, so I am about to work out. It is almost 5 o'clock on Sunday. It is going to be the first time I've worked out since last week, I think. Well, unless you want to count me working out for moving, which I guess kind of counts, but I'm going to run for the first time in a very long time. My goal is to run for 27 minutes. I should be able to do it unless I decide to cough up a lung because I am still sick, but we'll see how it goes. Okay, so I just got back from running on the treadmill, doing the couch to 5K, and I just think I blew the couch to 5K workout out of the water, being done with the 9 weeks. And now it is time to train for running the 10K with Shanti, which I am totally excited about. I just need to get my ability to run long distance longer. But today I ran for, I don't really know how long exactly it was, because I accidentally shut off the treadmill. I'm working out in a new gym, and so I accidentally shut off the treadmill. And so I stopped at 27 minutes, and then I was running for about 2 minutes, and then I shut it off again by accident because I hit the little, stopper thing, and then I ran for 10 minutes, and for an extra 10 minutes, so that would be 29. I ran for 39 minutes, which is ridiculous. Okay, so the first thing that I accomplished is I ran a mile in just under 10 minutes. I haven't been able to do that since high school, and oh my gosh, it feels amazing to have done that. Second of all, I ran over 3 miles, which is, I'm pretty sure I ran about 3.4 miles or so total, and that's above a 3K, or a 5K, I mean. So, I can run a 5K now, and I'm totally excited. I'm not exactly sure how fast it was total. Next time I go on the treadmill, I'll figure it out better. But this new treadmill that I'm on, the speeds are a lot different than the treadmill I'm used to. I was running at a 6.2 on this treadmill, but I felt like I was fine. I was at a 6.2 the entire time. But when I was at my treadmill at the old gym I was working out at, I was running at about a 4.3, 4.4. So I'm not exactly sure how fast I was actually running, because I think that number I was running on was off. So I'm really happy about it. I can run a 5K now, so now it's just time to start training for the 10K
So I am
So, question of the week. This week's question is how procrastination affects our weight loss and how it affects the way we go about our weight loss. And one of the things for me is that I am always saying, oh, tomorrow I'll do it. Oh, tomorrow's a new day. Oh, I'll just do it tomorrow. Tomorrow's been the next day. But you know what? For 3 years, that tomorrow never came until I found the weight loss YouTube community. Like, that tomorrow never came, and I still find myself doing it today. Like, thinking, oh, tomorrow I'll do it. Tomorrow will be that. Oh, tomorrow I'll work out. Today, whatever. I'm not going to work out. But once you get into that mentality of I'll do it tomorrow, it never happens. And tomorrow never happens. You have to do it today. So the procrastination thing is one of the things that really just kind of got me to being 213 pounds. And when I stopped procrastinating, it was when I actually got my ass into gear and I ended up losing 30 pounds. But now that procrastination is coming back into play, I gained 2.5 pounds like I did this week. So I just need – procrastination is such a thing that has caused me to gain so much weight and caused a lot of people out there I know just to, like, realize, oh, whatever, I'll do it tomorrow. And tomorrow has to be today, so.
The challenge this week that was made by Alex was I had to make up a workout. I didn't videotape myself doing it, but I did make it up, and here it is. So it's just kind of like an at-home workout where you do lunges, squats, push-ups, lunges with bench press, like with shoulder press and stuff like that. It just kind of was something that I kind of like just took workout videos that I've done in the past and just kind of added it together. And I think it totaled out to be about 20 minutes or so. So I'm thoroughly happy with the fact I was able to make up a workout plan. So I'm very happy about that. This challenge for you this week is I want you to work out twice a day, three times this week. I think you can do it. Just wake up that. It doesn't even have to be like a long exercise. It can just be like going on a half an hour walk really quickly. And then, yeah, just I think you can do it. Just do work out twice a week, three times this week. So, or twice a day, three times this week, and you can do it. Best of luck to you, girl. Oh, this week's weigh-in is 179.5. I know it's not the greatest, but you know what? Those gains happen, and with all the stress that I've been going on in my life, I'm okay with that. It happens, and this is a new week, and I just gotta take it one day at a time and make the correct choices that I know I can make. Alex, on the other hand, did fabulously. She lost 2.5. pounds this week, so she's down to I think 185.5, which is amazing. I am so proud of her right now, and she's able to lose weight even with all the stresses that she's got going on right now. So Alex, props to you. You're doing amazing. So yeah, just put those challenges down there and I'll get to it, because make them interesting, make them fun, and I will see you guys later. Bye.